Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up vendors in QuickBooks Online. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. If you are paying bills in QuickBooks, then you definitely want to set up your vendors. Setting up your vendors will allow you to do a couple of things. First, quickly enter vendor bills with information like remit to address and due date automatically pre-populated from the vendor profile. It will allow you to also keep track of your expenses by vendor. This will allow you to run reports that will provide insight into which vendors you are spending the most money with and what items you are purchasing from them. First, we'll explain how to manually set up vendors in QuickBooks. However, if you have more than 10 vendors to set up in QuickBooks, I recommend that you proceed to the next section of this lesson, how to set up vendors using an Excel or CSV file. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. After you sign into your QuickBooks Online account, click on the vendors icon on the left-hand side, and then click on New Vendor. This is a new vendor setup screen that we need to complete. So we'll go ahead and set up a vendor called Supplies R Us for Paul. In this first field, we're going to enter the company name. This is the information that will appear on all bills and purchase orders that you create. The display name field will automatically populate based on the information that you entered into the company field. The print on check field will also automatically populate based on the above field. If for some reason the payee is different from the company name, then you can remove the check mark here and enter the company name that the check should be made payable to. Here we want to enter the address where you need to mail your payments to, also known as the remit to address. You're also able to capture the contact email information, so we want to go ahead and put that in. In the next fields, you want to capture the contact telephone number for your vendor. You can also capture the cell phone information if you have that, as well as the fax number. In the next field, we're going to go ahead and put the website for our vendor. Payment terms. In the How to Set Up Expenses lesson, we set up default payment terms for all vendors. If you want to change the default payment terms for any vendor, you can do so here in this vendor profile. So we will go ahead and set payment vendor terms of net 30. Tax ID. You need to request a tax ID or social security number from all suppliers, since this is a key piece of information that you will need for the 1099 tax form. When preparing 1099 forms, QuickBooks will take the tax ID information from here. If you do not have the tax ID number for a vendor, you will not be able to print a 1099 form. You want to also mark this Track Payments for 1099 box. QuickBooks will track these vendors and include them on a 1099 report. If the supplier is not incorporated, you are required to send them a 1099 tax form if you pay them $600 or more in a calendar year. Before you issue the first payment to a 1099 vendor, ask them to supply you with a completed W-9 form. This form will have all of the key pieces of information that you will need in order to create a 1099 form. Once you have completed all of the fields for the vendor, you can go ahead and save that information. There are a few additional fields of information that you can capture for your vendor. Attachments. You can attach any document that you would like to keep on file for your vendors. So for example, the W-9 form, you can attach here to keep it on file. Any signed contracts or copies of email correspondence are also good files to attach to your vendor profile. The billing rate. You can enter the billing rate for this vendor here for easy reference. So if you have a standard bill rate that you pay to your supplier, you can enter that information in this field. Opening balance. This field can be used to enter an outstanding balance that you have with a vendor. For example, if you are converting from another bookkeeping system to QuickBooks and you have some outstanding bills, then you can enter the total outstanding balance here when you set them up in QuickBooks. When you write a check to pay those bills, then you can apply the payment to this opening balance. If you have an account number with your vendor, you can enter it here for easy reference. The notes field allows you to capture information that is just internal to your company. It will not be visible to your suppliers. So you can enter some information here, for example, an additional contact person. Once you have completed all the necessary fields for your new vendor, then you can save it. And this will take us back to the vendor center. We should now be able to see our new vendor supplies are us on our vendor list here. And that wraps up how to manually set up vendors in QuickBooks Online. If you have more than 10 vendors to set up, I would recommend that you put the information in an Excel document and import the data into QuickBooks Online. This will save you a lot of time over manual entry. QuickBooks allows you to capture a lot of data about your vendors, but the key fields that you should include in your Excel or CSV file are the first and last name of individual vendors, the company name for a business, email address, phone number, and remit to address where your payment should be mailed. Don't worry about the format of the spreadsheet. Just make sure that you have the above key fields in the spreadsheet. Once you have your spreadsheet ready, then you are ready to go ahead and import the data into QuickBooks. To import into QuickBooks, you want to go ahead and navigate to the Vendor Center. So we'll click on the vendor icon on the left icon bar, and then we will go ahead and click on the drop-down arrow to the right of New Vendor and select Import Vendors. On this screen, you want to go ahead and navigate by clicking on the Browse button and navigate to the Excel file that you saved on your computer. Once you find the file, select it and click Open. Verify that the correct file has populated in that box there. And if you want to see a sample Excel file, just click the Download a Sample File link here. Keep in mind that there is no need to reformat your spreadsheet. In the next step, we are going to map the data so that QuickBooks will pull the right data from your spreadsheet and import it correctly into QuickBooks. In this screen, we will tell QuickBooks which field in our spreadsheet to pull the information from. So by doing this, we will ensure that the information is imported into the right fields in QuickBooks. On the left-hand side, we have the QuickBooks Online field, and on the right-hand side, we've got the fields that are pulling from our spreadsheet. So as you can see, the first field here, QuickBooks has pulled vendor name, and the vendor name is being matched up with the name field in QuickBooks. That is correct. The second field here, or column in our spreadsheet, is called company. So QuickBooks has correctly matched that up with the company field in QuickBooks Online. Email address is the next column in our spreadsheet, and it has correctly pulled that as well. Notice the phone field has no match. So in our spreadsheet, we've got the phone field, but we've got it as the PH with the number sign. And so QuickBooks could not identify that, but that is the field that we want to pull the phone number from. So we'll make that selection there. We've also got a field for the mobile or cell number. QuickBooks was not able to match that, but when we click the drop down here, we can do that ourselves. And we don't have a cell phone number, so that should be a no match there. Going to the next field, we've got our fax number. So that was correctly matched by QuickBooks. In addition, QuickBooks has correctly matched our website information, street address has been matched, city, state, zip, our country field has been matched up correctly. Perfect. We do not have an opening balance in our Excel spreadsheet, so that should be a no match. Same with opening balance date. We do not have that information in our spreadsheet, so that should be a no match. Tax ID number we have, that's been correctly matched by QuickBooks. All right, so everything with a green check mark is going to be imported into QuickBooks. So once we are satisfied that this is the correct data, we can go ahead and click Next. And in this screen, you want to check a couple of things. You want to make sure that the number of records that QuickBooks has agrees with your spreadsheet. So here we've got 7 vendor records ready to be imported, and that matches the number of vendor records that we have in our Excel spreadsheet. The second thing that you want to do is make sure that the information that QuickBooks has in each of the columns is actually the information that should be imported. So for example, the name column is the company name. Company field is the company name. email address is pulling email information. You'll notice that some of the vendors we don't have email information for, and that's perfectly fine. Those fields will be blank. Make sure the phone number column has the phone number, fax, website, street address, etc. So all of these look good, and so we can go ahead and import this data into QuickBooks. Once the import is complete, QuickBooks will provide us with a message that says that the import was successful. There it is. So next step, you're going to have on occasion the need to actually modify information as it changes for a vendor. So you can easily change or update vendor information at any time. To do this, you just want to click on the vendor from the Vendor Center here. And then in the upper right-hand corner, you can click the Edit button. And you can change any information that you need to in this screen, and then go ahead and save your changes. Similar to customers, you cannot delete a vendor once you have used them in a transaction. For example, once you have created a check to pay a vendor, that is considered a transaction. This check or transaction is linked to financial statements, and those financial statements will be used when you file your taxes. However, if you decide that you no longer will do business with the vendor, you can inactivate a vendor just like you can inactivate a customer. Inactivating the vendor will simply hide the vendor from the Vendor Center, but they will still appear in all financial records if there has been a transaction. To inactivate a vendor from the Vendor Center, you want to go ahead and navigate back to the Vendor Center. We'll go ahead and select a vendor to inactivate. So in this case, we will inactivate the DMV. So we'll click on this vendor, and then we'll go ahead and click the Edit button in the upper right-hand corner. And at the bottom of the screen, you'll see the Make Inactive button here. So we'll go ahead and select that. QuickBooks will confirm, are you sure that you want to inactivate this vendor? And yes, we do. So we will go ahead and select yes. We'll go back to the Vendor Center, and that vendor will no longer appear on the list. That wraps up the section on how to set up vendors in QuickBooks Online. To access this course or any of the others in the series, or for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online, click the links below this video. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.